My name is Randi Terry, and I decided to do my project on 5 Seconds of Summer because they have been my favorite band since I was in the sixth grade. They're an Australian band, actually, and they have 4 studio albums out currently. They're considered an indie pop rock group right now, but they have also been called punk pop rock and even a boy band in the past. They don't really have the boy band title anymore because they play their own instruments and they're more rock-based than most boy bands. But the group consists of Luke Hemmings, Michael Clifford, Callum Hood, and Ashton Irwin. The band started in 2011, and their style has changed over the years, but the one central element that they have always kept is their rock roots. So Luke Hemmings is the lead vocalist, and he plays rhythm guitar. He's 23 years old, and he is credited with starting the band. He began posting YouTube videos of himself covering songs in February of 2011, then was later joined by the other members. Fans typically recognize him for his rich, full singing voice and his wide range. He's currently living in Los Angeles, California with his girlfriend, Sierra. Michael Clifford is also a vocalist, and he plays lead guitar. He's 24 years old. He is credited with naming the band. He was writing down nonsense combinations of words in his high school science class and stumbled across the name 5 Seconds of Summer. He appeared in a YouTube video with Luke shortly after the first video was posted. He started out as the lead guitarist, drummer, and bassist because he was talented with all three. Fans typically recognize him for his wild hair and raspy, rock-like vocals. He currently lives in Los Angeles, California with his fiancée, Crystal Lee. Callum Hood is also a vocalist and he plays bass guitar. Callum is 24 years old. He appeared in the next video posted after Michael joined Luke on YouTube, and the three of them continued to post covers until 2012. Callum did not know how to play any instruments when he joined the band, and he ended up learning bass because he had trouble learning guitar. Fans typically recognize Callum for his slightly different accent. He's actually from New Zealand rather than Australia, although he did live most of his life in Australia, and his breathy, higher-pitched singing style. He currently lives in Los Angeles with his dog, Duke. Ashton Irwin, he's the drummer and he's also a vocalist. I say they're all vocalists because a big part of their style is their ability to harmonize, and they've always said that that was something that was very important to them in their music, is their harmonies. So they all do sing because they all work on their harmonies. Ashton's 25 years old. He was the last member to join the band. Michael found him on Facebook and asked him to be their drummer because they needed a drummer to play live performances. They performed their first gig as a band in 2011 to an audience of 12 people. He's credited for writing most of the band's early music, though he sings the lead solos. Fans typically recognize him for his smooth harmonizing with the other members. He currently lives in Los Angeles with his girlfriend, KK. Their first album, self-titled 5 Seconds of Summer, was released by Capitol Records on June 27, 2011. What really gave them worldwide recognition, though, was being the opening act for One Direction, and this is also where they picked up their boy band title. Their first album had their first major hits like She Looks So Perfect and Amnesia. Their upbeat, popish style, along with their youth and association with One Direction, helped them gain traction with the 1D fan base. But their more rock-based music and alternative teenage style helped them gain their own loyal fan base, many of whom have stuck with them for the past 6 years. I'm an example of that. I did not find them through One Direction, but here I am. So this is She Looks So Perfect. It is actually probably their most popular quote-unquote song, because a lot of people that don't know who they are will still recognize this song. If you don't swim, you'll drown. But don't move, honey. Well, sorry the video buffered, but this is Amnesia.
I drove by all the places we used to hang out, getting wasted. I thought about our last kiss, how it felt, the way it tasted. And even though your friends tell me you're doing fine, are you somewhere feeling lonely, even though he's right beside you? When he says those words that hurt you, do you read the ones I wrote you? Sometimes I start to wonder, was it just a lie? What we had was real, how could you be fine?
Well, I guess all the videos are gonna buffer. Sorry. So, their second album was Sounds Good, Feels Good, and it was released on October 23rd, 2015. They were actually pretty annoyed by their boy band label, and they decided to explore their punk rock side and also pushed harder for more emotional lyrics to show their growing maturity. The only really commercially successful song off the second album was Jet Black Heart, and though their second album enjoyed less success than their first, it helped them solidify a rock fan base that enjoyed their music for more than just the boy band aspect. So this is where they got their fan base that was not necessarily One Direction fan base. This is Jet Black Heart, and you'll also notice that Michael is singing the lead, so if you remember earlier I said that he has the rock vocals, this is where they are. And so this is She's Kinda Hot, which is just another song off of Sounds Good, Feels Good.
My girlfriend's bitching cause I always sleep in. She's always screaming when she's calling her friends. She's kinda hot though. Yeah, she's kinda hot though.
And their third studio album, Youngblood, was released on June 15th, 2018. After Sounds Good, Feels Good, they took a 3-year hiatus to deal with some personal problems, i.e. a devastating breakup and a heavy drug use for Luke, and to write Youngblood. After the relative flop of their second album, they were determined to take their time and produce a better quality album that would be more successful. Leaving their punk side in the past with their teenage years, Youngblood had more heartbroken songs, such as Lie to Me, but they still clung to their rock roots with songs such as Youngblood. So this is Lie to Me. Very, very sad.
Now I wish we never met, cause you're too hard to forget. While I'm cleaning up your mess, I know we're taking off your dress. I know that you don't, but if I ask you if you love me, hope you lie to me.
And this is Youngblood. Calm was released on March 22nd, 2020, so it's still very new. As of now, the album's been pretty successful, but they haven't been able to promote it like the others because of COVID-19. It has some inspiration from the Beatles and Queen in harmonies, but they've also stuck pretty close to the style of Youngblood and, of course, their rock roots. So this is actually my favorite song that they've ever released. It's called Lover of Mine.
Lover of mine, maybe we'll take this home time. Kaleidoscope mind gets in the way. Hope and I pray, darling, that you will stay. Butterfly lights chase them away. Dance around the lake.
And this is Teeth, and this is one of their more rocky songs that's off of Calm.
Call me in the morning to apologize.